What does it mean to lift the hair? Well, in the hairdressing world, lifting is equally translated to lightening. You've got hair that is naturally black, brown, light brown, blonde, and each one of those has a level. We use a scale of 1 to 10, 1 being black and 10 being ultra light blonde. So the scientific process of lightening the hair involves some sort of lightener. And in that lightener is ammonia. And ammonia is what swells the cuticle of the hair open. The lightener goes inside and starts breaking down that actual melanin, that black, that brown, and all of that underlying pigment starts to show up, and you keep lifting levels 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 until that perfect blonde. And that, in a nutshell, is what lightening the hair actually means. A simple analogy for hair lightening in an everyday world would be, have you ever gotten cleaning bleach on your black pants? Well, what color does those black pants turn? It goes from a black to an orange. Well, in the hairdressing world, everybody's hair has underlying pigment. Dark brown, medium brown, light brown. When you put lightener on the hair to go lighter, you're exposing all of those underlying pigments. And it is essentially the same thing that happens to your hair that happens to your clothes. If you're lightening and it's done incorrectly, there are a few issues you could run into. Dryness. Ugh, does anybody have any chapstick? Or breakage. Your hair could snap right in the middle if you're not lightening properly. And lastly, but certainly not least, porosity, leaving actual holes in your hair. With all that being said, lifting someone with virgin black hair all the way to platinum blonde in a day without major damage sounds crazy, because it really used to be. Hair integrity became more of a focus only in the last 5 to 10 years. All the way back to 29 AD, leeches and vinegar were fermented in a lead pot and were applied to the hair under the sunlight to get the most desirable hue. But that often resulted in lead poisoning. Sounds like a witch's brew for blondes. In later centuries, becoming blonde became extremely expensive as well. It was achieved with a seriously expensive mix of cumin seeds, saffron, oil, and celandine. Basically, only ingredients the rich could afford. Ironically, in ancient Greece, yellow hair eventually became a symbol of barbarians and prostitution. So women with light hair usually dyed their hair dark to be considered more beautiful. Good, bad, or indifferent, blondes have always been the talk of the town, regardless of the methods used to achieve it. Blonde icons such as Grace Kelly, Marilyn Monroe, Jean Harlow, who dared to be blonde, would often leave the beauty shop with violent headaches, swollen eyelids, and blisters on their foreheads. In fact, according to Miss Harlow's hairdresser, he used peroxide, ammonia, Clorox, and Lux Flakes to dye her hair, an absolutely toxic mix of chemicals, which we're not saying was a contributor to her early demise at age 26. It wasn't until around 2014, just about 5 years ago, that bonding additives hit the center stage and disrupted the hair industry, adopted by hairdressers the world over. But what is bonding? Simply put, bonding is a way to protect the inside of the hair while lightening. Essentially, everybody's hair is made up of fibers connected by bonds in between. When you put lightener on the hair, it swells the cuticle and it goes in and has the tendency to break apart these bonds that hold your hair fibers together. When you add a bonding agent to your lightener, you're essentially protecting those bonds that hold your hair fibers together, strengthening the inner hair structure. With bonding technology going from dark to light in just one day is not nearly as risky as using just Clorox and peroxide.